So we are going to study transpose of a matrix. Transpose of a matrix is simply, if I'm taking an example, through that example I'm going to explain you. A is this matrix 2×3. A transpose, or you write T or you write A dash. Transpose means that all the rows will be adjusted into columns. So x, y, z, you can see that x, y, z has been now converted into this, into column. And second row, again, you can see here, they are adjusted into second column. So it means that transpose of a matrix is simply interchanging of rows and columns. So the definition can be seen based on the words which I have said, the interchanging of rows and columns. Properties of transpose. If I do the transpose twice, then it becomes the original matrix. And if I do the transpose of A plus B whole transpose, then it becomes A transpose plus B transpose. K A transpose means K here is a scalar, then K will be is a scalar, and K A dash, it will be fourth one is A B whole transpose will be equal to B transpose A transpose. Now come to the second thing, symmetric matrix. Any matrix, if they satisfy this condition, means if you do the transpose and and you get back the original matrix, then the matrix will be called symmetric matrix. For example, A 2 4 4 3, I have done the transpose, I have taken transpose both side, then A transpose will be 2 4, and I have changed the rows 2 4 2 4 4 3 4 3, so it becomes the again this original one, which is A. So we can say A is a symmetric matrix. Now come to the skew symmetric matrix. If A transpose equal to minus A, then we say A is a skew symmetric matrix. For example, take this matrix 3×3 order. This is 0 1 2 minus 1 0 3 minus 2 minus 3 0 0 1 2 minus 1 0 3 minus 2 minus 3 0. So you can see that I have applied the transpose, then it becomes 0 1 2 1 minus 1 0 3 and minus 2 minus 3 0 this. Now from all the elements you take minus common, then this 0, this minus 1 will become plus 1, this minus 2 will become plus 2, plus 1 will become minus 1, and this way. And the matrix that you obtained after taking out minus common is actually your A with negative sign. So it shows that A transpose is B transpose equal to minus B. So B is a skew symmetric matrix. Now come to the important theorems. Theorem number one says, for any matrix A with real number entries, then A plus A dash is a symmetric and A minus A dash is a skew symmetric matrix. The results always holds. This is theorem. So you have to just remember the result of the theorems. Though the proof can be seen, or we can do the proof in the next video also. Theorem 2. Any square matrix can be expressed as the sum of a symmetric and a skew symmetric matrix. Means A is 1 by 2 A plus A transpose plus 1 by 2 A minus A transpose. So that part, first part is your symmetric matrix. Second part is your skew symmetric matrix. We have used this result that A plus A will be a symmetric and A minus A will be a skew symmetric matrix. Again, the proof is very easy, can be proved. So after doing these basic things, now we'll move to the questions based on transpose and symmetric and skew symmetric matrix. Okay, to the questions in exercise 3.3. I'm taking question number 6 first. Rest of the questions are very basic questions. You may try after knowing what is transpose and skew and symmetric, skew symmetric and symmetric matrices. Okay, A is cos alpha sin alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha. Then verify that A transpose into A equal to I. So I have found first A transpose, you see the row cos alpha sin alpha. Now it has come here, cos alpha sin alpha cos alpha it has come sin alpha cos alpha. Then I have taken the LHS side, A transpose into A. So this is A transpose, which we have obtained now. Cos alpha sin alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha. And this is the original matrix A cos alpha minus sin alpha cos alpha. I have multiplied by using the multiplication method. So cos into cos square alpha minus sin into minus sin plus sin square alpha. Then cos alpha into sin alpha minus sin alpha into cos alpha. Sin alpha cos alpha minus cos alpha sin alpha. And then sin alpha sin square alpha cos into cos square alpha. So this becomes 1, this becomes 0, this becomes 0, this becomes 1. So this is equal to I equal to RHS. Now come to question number 7. Though question number 7 is very easy, once you know how to check whether the given matrix is a symmetric matrix or not. But above that, I am just going to explain you with the help of the definition of a transpose of matrix. See, A transpose is equal to A. We know that if matrix is symmetric matrix, then A transpose is equal to A. So it implies A means the elements are of Aij form. I represent row, J represent column. So Aij transpose equal to Aij. I have just taken this matrix form. Then Ij ko you interchange the rows and column, then it becomes Ji equal to Aij. So this is very important result. See, there is no need to do actually the transpose. Without even doing transpose, you can come to know whether this matrix is a symmetric matrix or a skew symmetric matrix. So you see Aji equal to Aij. It means what? It means if this is your A12 position, if this is your A12 position, then A21 position will be same. You can see minus 1, this is minus 1. And if this is A13 position, then this A31 position will be same. If this is your A23 position, then this is A32 position will be same. And diagonal matrix can be, diagonal elements can be any. So it just talks about the element other than the diagonal matrix. And if they are same this way, then we say this is a symmetric matrix, whatever diagonal elements are. The second, this one, A is this matrix. We have to show this is a skew symmetric matrix. Though you can do the transpose and check whether it is coming this or not. If it is yes, then you will say symmetric matrix. But now I'm using a result, and that is also very important to understand, because without even doing the transpose, we can come to know whether this is a symmetric matrix or not. We know A transpose equal to minus A in case of skew symmetric matrix. It means Aij transpose, Aij means the elements, equal to this Aij, for all ij, I represent for rows, j represent for columns. So Aji will be equal to minus Aij. So this is the first result. What do you think? It means if it is my A21 position, if it is A21 position, then it will be equal to A12. This is A12 position, then A21 position will be same, but only the sign will be different. So here it is plus sign, here it is minus sign. You see here it is A13 and this is A31. This sign is minus, this sign is plus. Numerical value will remain the same, only the sign will be opposite to each other. Similarly, here also you see. So this is about the non-diagonal elements. Come to the diagonal elements. What happens in the diagonal elements? See, Aji equal to Aij minus Aij. This we have seen. Now put J equal to I. In this equation, put J equal to I. Then Aii equal to minus Aii. Bring it here to Aii equal to 0. Implies Aii equal to 0. This is the important second result. Aii means row and column are same. So row and column here, this is A11, 0. This is A22, 0. A23 is 0. So This is very important thing that you should keep in mind, though this may not be asked in the exam. You just remember how to, you know, find out whether this is a skew symmetric or symmetric matrix without taking transpose. But taking transpose is even, I feel, simpler way. So you can go ahead with that method of that you check A transpose equal to minus A or not. So this is about symmetric and skew symmetric. We'll discuss after this something else now.